Hello everyone, welcome back to Chemical Engineering and Assessment channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 43 for our valuable viewers. And in this lecture, we will be again moving to the chapter number 8, which is Multiple Reactions. Last video, we have just overviewed that what we will be reading or studying in this chapter, and we had seen a bit of the initial part, but now we will be moving to the major terms of this chapter, which are selectivity, yield, and then the importance of these two terms, and then we will solve an example related to it. So talking about the selectivity, it tells us how one product is favored over another when we have multiple reactions in the system. In the previous lecture, I have told you that multiple reactions are very often, once we talk about the real-time scenario, single reactions are very rare in the system. So once there are multiple reactions, obviously you have multiple products, and among these there will be desired products and there will be some undesired products. So we have to obviously economically see that our desired product is in maximum quantity and the undesired product is in minimum quantity. So the selectivity is one of the parameters which tells us that how we can increase or how one product is favored over another in case of multiple reactions. We can quantify the formation of D with respect to the formation of Q by defining the selectivity and yield of the system. Now in selectivity, we have two parameters, instantaneous selectivity and overall selectivity. Now the instantaneous selectivity is defined as the ratio of rate of formation of D and rate of formation of U. Means these two parameters are divided, R of D over R of U. While the overall selectivity is the same, but instead of rate, we are talking about the exit molar flow rate of D to the exit molar flow rate of U. Or if we talk about the batch systems, then we will say the number of moles. So these are the two definitions of instantaneous and overall selectivity, which takes into account the formation of one product to the formation of an other product. In case of instantaneous selectivity, it will be the rate, and in case of overall selectivity, it will be the flow rate. Now talking about the yield, again the yield has two definitions, instantaneous yield and overall yield, just like we have seen the instantaneous selectivity and overall selectivity. So the instantaneous yield, the formula is the rate of formation of the desired product divided by the rate of consumption or rate of disappearance of the limiting reactant or the key reactant, which is A in the system. While in case of overall yield, it will be defined as the number of moles of D, which is the desired product produced, divided by the number of moles of A, which is the limiting reactant consumed. If this is a batch system, or in case of flow system, it will be the flow rate of desired product which is produced divided by the flow rate of the limiting reactant or the key reactant that is consumed in the system. So in case of the yield, it will be the product divided by the reactant. While in case of selectivity, it will be the product to an other product, means desired product to undesired product. Now economically, if we talk about what parameters are most important, the overall selectivity and overall yield is important while we are talking about the profits. While the instantaneous selectivity is helpful in deciding the reaction schemes, the reactors that will help maximize the profit. However, once we talk about the selectivity, then there is always a conflict between selectivity and conversion. Because obviously you want to maximize the desired product, but you want to at the same time minimize the undesired product. While the conversion, that does not take into account the desired or undesired. It is simply 80% of that conversion. So more will be the conversion, we say more will efficient will be the system. But in that system, we also want that our desired product is more. Obviously, okay, you have more conversion, but at the same time, you want to have maximum selectivity so that your desired product is maximum. So in many instances, the greater the conversion you achieve, not only do you make more D, but you also make more U. So accordingly, then you have to install a separation system to separate these two in the system. So going to the example, develop a relationship between S D by U and S D by U. This is instantaneous and this is overall selectivity for a continuous state tank reactor. And we have been given the two parallel reactions that A goes to D and the rate constant is K of D, and A goes to U, the rate constant is K of U. So instantaneous selectivity is defined as S D by U is equal to R D over R U, and overall selectivity is S D by U. Obviously, we can say something like that, and F D over F U. If we apply the mole balance on CSTR for product D, it will be F of D is equal to R D into V. And if we apply for product U, it will be F of U is equal to R U into V. So if we divide these two, this V will be cancelled out with this V. FD over FU is equal to RD over RU. Now that RD over RU is actually your instantaneous selectivity, while FD over FU is your overall selectivity. So these two selectivities are now equal. So what we conclude, obviously we had to develop a relationship, but with this relationship we can say that for a CSTR, the instantaneous selectivity is always equal to the overall selectivity. While that might not be the case for the differential reactors like the batch, PFR or PBR. So that's it from today's lecture. I hope you have understood all the aspects of this video. If you have any query, feedback, suggestion, please provide it in the comment box and I would be happy to answer it. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.